live and exclusive on ITV1, this is The Big Fight Live. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the ring from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, John Pascal.
Time to play the game. Time to play the game.
An intimidating atmosphere greets John Pascal, the 26-year-old from Montreal. Says he's mentally stronger than Carl Froch. Well, this will be the first moment that it's really being tested. Who are you? Who are you? The chants go up. Pascal will believe that he has the ability and the desire to show them exactly who he is and that he can be the world champion. He's got his conditioners with him, his nutritionists, his psychologists, camp followers, trainers, fitness coaches. There are any number of them at ringside. A fair few have made their way into the ring. And now we await the arrival of the Cobra, Carl Froch.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome from Nottingham,
formal announcements.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for our featured bout, and it is brought to you by Hennessy Sports in association with the Braithwaite House Hotel, County Mayo, Ireland, GoldenPalace.com, The Sun Newspapers, and Hooters of Nottingham. This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds, and it will be for the vacant WBC Super Middleweight Championship of the World. It is sanctioned by the World Boxing president is Jose Suleiman. Supervising tonight is Hussein Wishi, along with the British Boxing Board of Control. Steward in charge, Dave Roden. The chairman is Charles Giles. The three judges assigned, scoring on a 10-point must system will be Predrag Alexic of Montenegro, Ermino Cuevas of Mexico, and Tommy Kazmarek of the United States. When the bell rings, our referee in charge of the action will be Guido Cavalleri of Italy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, live from the Trent FM Arena, Nottingham, it's time for our main event of the evening. Introducing the team first, to my left in the blue corner, he's wearing black with yellow and weighed in at 11 stone, 13 pounds, 10 ounces. Coming to us from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, he brings with him a perfect record of 21 wins, no losses, with 14 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the current NABF, NABA, NABO, and WBO super middleweight champion, Jean Pascal. Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in the red corner, he's wearing black with gold and weighed in at 11 stone, 12 pounds, 9 ounces. Hailing from right here, Nottingham. He is undefeated with 23 wins, no losses, and 19 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the former unbeaten English, British, and Commonwealth super middleweight champion and the official WBC's number one ranked contender, Coral the Cobra Bruns.
Well, there seems to be literally of dozens of people up there in the ring now, in some cases a little bit reluctantly making their way out, and in a moment or two we'll have final instructions from the referee, Mr. Cavalleri, who took charge of David Hay against Jean-Marc Mormec last year, a fight which,
gentlemen,
of course, Hay won.
Remember what I told you in the restroom, okay? Chicken and good night.
And now the crowd raise their voices once again. Pascal, I wonder what thoughts are going through his head. He's been in training camp in Phoenix, Arizona, Carl Froch on the west coast of Ireland. Who's got it right? Pascal says he has the speed, and that is the key. Froch says he has the power, and his speed is underestimated. 12 rounds, world title now on the line. Good start from Froch. Straight away making Pascal feel the weight of his punches. And instantly they were on their feet all around this auditorium, roaring Froch on. Pascal, the Commonwealth Games champion in Manchester back in 2002. Carl Froch, England's first ever world amateur medalist. He won a bronze in 2001, and as a professional, unblemished, and he started confidently.
Froch has made a fantastic start, took the fight straight to Pascal, already got the nerves out of his system. Nice two-fisted attack on the ropes. Brilliant start by Froch, exactly what he needed.
Pascal reckons that he's modelled himself on Roy Jones Jr. Well, that is a mighty ambitious thing to be saying. Jones at his best, one of the outstanding fighters in the world since the war. Froch believes he has the superior power, and he's got a reach advantage. He's about an inch or so, maybe a couple of inches taller than Pascal, and with a reach advantage to match. Good combination.
Pascal trying to psych Froch out, trying to take his best shots and smile at him, just trying to show him that he can take the best shot. Froch doing the right thing, staying cool.
I have to say, Pascal looks in magnificent condition. You talk about a physique that's ripped, that really is.
Absolutely to the bone, ripped to the bone. Contrasting start to both boxers. Froch looked very pensive at the beginning, and Pascal, great right hand from Pascal.
That's the danger shot from Pascal. Froch has the tendency to drop that left-hand lead, and Pascal has a terrific right hand. He has real speed in that punch, and a lot of the damage that he's inflicted over his professional career has come from that right-hand side. Throws hurtful hooks as well. Good start from Froch, but that's another good shot from Pascal. Good body shot, and doubling up well to the head, and the right over the top. Already this is showing up to be a fascinating fight. Contrast of styles, Duke.
Sorry, John. Both boxers very nervous. Both boxers very nervous. What you're seeing now is tension and power controlled into one thing.
Fascinating opening round. Both fighters have landed big punches. Interesting opening round. Perhaps the most damaging punch was that right hand from Pascal. Froch took it well, though. Interesting opening round, and both fighters landing big shots. Bombs will be thrown in this fight, unquestionably. Big punches from both men, and we're only just over 3 minutes into it.
Yeah, Pascal already trying to put the right hand over the top of Froch's leading hand, his jab. As I said before, it's a little bit lazy, carries it low, likes to get lots of power on it, spring the shot up. But Pascal already trying to find a way through. Pascal's punches just seem to bother Froch just a little bit more than his did early on.
Pascal showing good hand speed. He said that it doesn't matter that Froch might have more power. He says, I have more speed, and everything comes from speed.
Pascal just getting a little bit too easy, getting through too easy with his right hand on Froch. I just like to him pull that hand up, because then he can still have the same effect with the jab, but he'll stop the right hands coming through.
Canadian champions in the past, people like David Hilton, Eric Luca. Can Pascal become another one? Good body shots from Froch. Pascal does no more than blink and takes them well.
And his mental strength is absolutely spot on. If you remember Timothy Bradley that was over here recently, that defeated Junior Witter, I see a very similar mindset with this young man. Very confident, very calm, very composed. Froch has to work him off that jab, get the right hand going off the jab.
The theory in the Froch camp was that Pascal would get wilder as the fight went on, as he got under more pressure. The theory in the Pascal camp was that their man would simply be too fast and outbox Froch and land punches like that right hand.
Well, there it is again. I don't understand Froch, because the guy's got every punch in the book. He's fit, he's strong, but he just allows himself to get clipped with that shot.
But he's never been down as an amateur or a professional, has Froch. Both of them landing heavy shots once more.
Froch looking to reassert himself. He knows he's got to take the play away from this kid.
Froch, 5 years, the older man. Both of them in professional terms, pretty much on a par. Does Froch have the harder punches? Well, make up your own mind as you watch this. Pascal won't believe so. And the Canadian fans watching, I'm sure, won't believe so. Good shots from both in the closing seconds. Big left hand from Pascal as Froch starts to unload to the body. Rich drama in the second round.
This one's really taken off.
Good rounds.
Chin on your chest, side to side, professional. Mate, come on. Don't
Nothing in this fight okay, so far. Both of them landing terrific shots. Who was landing the more purposeful ones? Well, it's anybody's guess. Nothing in it, Duke.
Absolutely nothing in it except for one shot right at the end from Pascal. A sweeping lift hook just caught Froch just momentarily as the bell sounded.
Difficult one to score. Froch maybe edged the first. How did he score the second, Duke?
Yeah, I've got it. One round each. Exactly one round each. First round Froch, second round Pascal. Froch isn't going to take him out with one shot. Froch normally has it his own way when he's fighting domestic opposition.
And it's turning into a real tear-up here in the third round.
Froch normally takes out guys with these shots, but he's fighting a world-class performer. Not going to take him out in one shot.
Robert McCracken, Froch's coach, was saying, don't just stand there, block these shots, parry them.
But he's going to have to work for this one. He's got to get that jab working and put the right hand behind it. Then bring the left hook into play.
Good left hand from Pascal again. Froch threw it just before that to throw in a really good, solid, authoritative left-hand lead. His corner will want him to deliver more of those.
Both boxers throwing absolute bombs in there, but it's classy stuff.
Good shot from Pascal. He's had a considerable amount of success with that right over the top. Quality uppercut from Froch. Great right hand. That gets them up at ringside. Well, this is a terrific fight so far. Can they maintain this sort of speed and power and intensity for anything like the 12 rounds for which it's scheduled? This is where all that conditioning and training comes into play. Big right hand again from Pascal, just shrugged off by Froch.
This really is edge of the seat stuff, because you just feel any one of these guys land, it's going to be all over.
Well, both of them landed simultaneously with tremendous left hands. Who's the harder puncher here? Who's actually inflicting the greater damage? Good left hand from Froch. Great
Froch
shot.
Is getting through. He's getting through. Lovely combos, but he's missing a lot, leaving himself wide open. Froch is leaving his chin out to dry when he's landing these shots. He's swinging them in. He's putting everything behind him. Has to have a breather. Takes a lot out of you when you're putting shots like that together.
Well, you can see Froch blowing. Pascal was on the receiving end for most of that, but didn't expend too much energy in that exchange. Can he now produce an eye-catching last 30 seconds to the third round? There's that big right hand again. And the other one only just misses him. Just for a moment, Froch just looked a little bit groggy there. And Froch wants to hold on by a few seconds.
That's Pascal's physical strength, throwing everything behind that punch and trying to get maximum power behind it. Just falling short with the right hand, but there's a big one that went over the top.
Big finish from Pascal, maybe. Back comes Froch in the closing seconds of the round. Shrugged his shoulders and said, here, have some more.
Don't get force ridiculous. Come on. Carl, you've got to do it, mate.
Dramatic fight round so far. Four. Pascal's corner saying, work the body. And Froch's trainer, Robert McCracken, just urging his man towards composure. Only three rounds gone. What drama already.
Well, Froch had the better of that exchange. The harder punches, he got through with the bigger punches. He got through, but now he's got to regroup, repace, keep his composure, and get back to boxing. Look to put the right hand through. It's a fantastic shot when he throws it. Pascal's right eye is just starting to pop up just ever so slightly.
He's already shown that he's got a good chin, though, Pascal. Taking some great shots from Froch, which have many a time put his previous opponents away.
But Pascal, a little bit wild, a little bit ragged, isn't as refined as Froch when he puts his combinations together, but the power is good. There it is again. There's another testament to what I just said. His overall power is good. A double jab and a right hand from Pascal. Looking for the right hand again.
Maybe the fight will just quieten down a little bit after that almost frenetic opening three rounds. That's a good right hand from Froch. solid right, landed pretty much on the button and Pascal took it, but now wants to just hold on for a moment. And Pascal, both eyes, just starting to mark up a little bit. They're swelling, I think, around both eyes.
Yeah, both boxers fighting on nervous energy, trying to load up with everything they throw. It takes a lot out of you. It's no wonder it's got a little bit scrappy. Haymakers coming in from the outset.
Pascal has had only one fight this year, back in January, Karl Frotsch. Similarly, relatively inactive as he waited for his big opportunity. Oh, terrific right hand from Frotsch.
But didn't he take it well, Pascal?
Certainly that
was flush.
May have just stunned him, though. That's a good left hand from Pascal. Oh, and another terrific shot from Frotsch.
And back he comes. Back he comes. Frotsch just got the upper hand with that attack. But Pascal comes straight back. Oh!
Big right hand from Pascal and the left, and now Frotsch just wants to hold on for a moment.
Oh, this is so exciting. Let me tell you, Frotsch took a right hand, gave a right hand in return, and I tell you, I don't know how one of these guys haven't gone down.
Both of them showing a granite chin. The old Rocky cliche, not so much what you can give out, what you can take as well. And that is being shown emphatically here in Nottingham tonight. This WBC World Super Middleweight title is starting to shape up to be a classic. Another big right hand from Pascal. And Frotsch looks a little bit uneasy.
There's the
big
right
uppercut.
There's the right hand again from Pascal. Just this little onslaught is just a bit tidier and cleaner than Frotch's.
It's turning out to be a macho tear up here in Nottingham. Huge punches landed by both men.
Round five.
And nothing to choose between them right now.
Well, what it is, Frotsch has been drawn into a fight with this guy. The crowd have inspired him, but he's getting drawn into a fight. His corner is so right, he could make this a lot easier than what it is if he didn't try to fight with Pascal. But he's been drawn into a fight, looking for the knockout, wants to impress the fans.
Pascal's been told to just work away to the body, keep working hard, look for those right hands. Frotsch has been told, get back to your boxing. You're making this hard for yourself by getting into a toe-to-toe brawl. So many of those right hands have been landing for Pascal. They've got to have a cumulative effect.
They have to have an effect. I would love to see Frotsch get his hands up, but he won't. He's got to do it his way. But his way might be the hard way. Got to work that jab, Frotsch. You've got to work that jab. At the moment, he's too upright. He's too stationary. Not creating any angles to punch from, Frotsch.
Pascal, enormously popular in Canada, and you can see just why. Both of them, I suspect, in this fifth round, feeling the pace.
Absolutely.
Almost for the first time, the action just starts to slow a little.
Absolutely, John, you're so right, it's the pace. Beautiful left hook by Pascal.
There, good hand speed from both men. They land simultaneously with colossal shots. Has Frotsch taken more there than Pascal in that exchange? Maybe. Both of them landed almost simultaneously.
Well, I tell you what, Frotsch can take a shot. Never that his chin was ever in question, but I tell you, he's taking some cracking right hands and they bounced off that granite jaw chin.
What a superb fight we have so far.
Frotsch is noted for his boxing ability, but what we're seeing today is he's demonstrating raw strength.
And fighting instinct from both men. Quiet around this one. Frotsch working the body and staying out of the way of the slightly wild left hook counter. Frotsch concentrating on the straight shots more in this round. Boxing his way, working behind the jab.
And blowing quite heavily, Frotsch, because he's put so much into these early rounds in terms of power. I don't like to see Frotsch getting hit like this.
And this is dangerous times. Good shots from Pascal. Oh, that's a terrific body shot. Great left hook from Pascal. Really breathed hard when that one landed, Karl Frotsch.
Well, this really is the acid test for Frotsch. He's got to show that he's world class. He's got to really find a different plan to beat this kid.
Has he been the flat track bully? Is he truly world class? Well, we're finally out here, and Punch is off to the bell. Punch is off to the bell from Pascal. You cannot do that. You cannot do
that.
Well, the referee lost control in the closing stages there. Punch has thrown after the round ended. And Guido Cavalieri having words with Pascal, who was clearly the one who was beyond the rules. And he will have more words now with Pascal. Pascal lucky not to have a point deducted. And the referee will have no more of it. There are protests from the Prox corner, quite rightly so. And Pascal being told by his own corner men, don't do that, don't go wild, behave like a champion. So much at stake, so much.
That's a beautiful jab from Froch. The first one got through as flush as you like. Just waiting a little bit too long. Pascal waiting for Froch to lead off, and then he's counting with a hook to the body, hook to the head.
Now how on earth did he score that last round, Duke?
I gave the last round even because they both scored with equally amount of damaging blows.
Very little between them. I reckon Pascal may be just edging it, but not much between them.
I'd like to see Froch inject some pace in the fight and really push this kid. I mean, we both know they're superior athletes. The pair of them are trained really, really hard, peak condition. But I'm sure Froch has got another level he can go to.
Pascal just allowing Froch to be the first here. That's a decent shot from Pascal, but pretty much his first of the round. Now he does try to unload with that left-hand, right-hand combination. The overhand right so often has been a scoring shot for Jean Pascal.
Pascal trying to work on the inside. Froch's long arms just keeping him off. It's a better round by Froch, just using the jab just enough to keep Pascal off him. Quieter round as you would expect. They put so much into this fight.
Very little from Pascal so far in this round, but the last minute, as any fighter would tell you, can sometimes be key. It's the old pro's trick. Give it when the seconds are ticking away, and that's a terrific right hand from Pascal. But Froch again, granite chinned, just blinks and takes it and tries to return with interest.
Absolutely. But what Pascal's doing, he's throwing the right hand and running in after it. That's what's catching Froch out. I still think Froch is winning this round, though, because he's using that jab to good effect. Pascal may be taking the round off and having a breather.
Well, Froch now tries to make him pay. Again, the Nottingham crowd up on his feet, roaring the hero on. Well, what a fight this is turning out to be. One straying low from Pascal. Chopping right from Froch was a hurtful punch. And the British fighter has dominated this round for the most part.
Yeah, he certainly has. It's been a good round from Froch.
Foot off the gas from Jean Pascal. Froch clearly taking that round. They are absolutely loving it here.
Listen, he's going to get desperate and he's going to start swinging back again. Push your move at your feet now and rolling under. You're getting out of the way. If you stand up straight, hit you with that silly right hand, all right?
For the most part, it was jabs from Froch which were winning the fight. But then came those big rights from Pascal.
He puts his head down, doesn't even look to see where it's going, but it lands straight over Froch's jab. Just out of sorts with that one. But for the most part, for me, in that round, it was a clear Froch round.
Pascal from Haiti, French speaker, his trainer Mark Ramsey, along with Dino Macatello, and there's the scorecard as we have it at ringside at the moment. That's Duke McKenzie, three weights world champion, fine boxer in his time. That's how Duke's got it.
Yeah, I've just got Froch just that one round up. That last round for me was a good round for him, and he started this round exactly the same. Lovely right hands from Froch, looking for the uppercut, looking for the right uppercut. This is good stuff.
Pascal just starting to not have the speed that he had in the earlier rounds. He's just starting to be just that little bit more deliberate, less instinctive, blinking a bit and feeling the cumulative effect of the weight of Crotch's punches. Maybe, but still dangerous, still able to capitalise himself.
Yeah, Pascal starting to look a little bit tired now, probably from the early rounds, obviously it's caught up with him. His crotch is just a little bit fresher right now. Again, that right eye from Pascal swelling by the second, which is encouraging for Crotch.
Crotch just content now to work behind the jab and outbox Pascal. That's the tactic. Nothing so far in this round from the Canadian. Just waiting for Crotch to commit himself. But is he waiting too long? Feints to throw it and thinks better of it.
Yeah, Pascal just being a bit lazy now. Not prepared to work back, not prepared to throw anything in return. Waiting for one mistake from Crotch. But as he waits, he's getting outboxed.
Almost unbearably dramatic the first few rounds of this fight. And now Crotch, has he settled into a rhythm? Pascal, a couple of meaty-looking body shots.
Pascal is a very loose defence, tries to ride punches without his hands up.
The right eye of Pascal is worsening by the second. There's a real mouth starting to swell underneath there. And there's blood as well now coming from the nose of the Canadian. Pascal gave it a tremendous start, landed some superb punches. I'm sure he can hardly believe that Crotch took them and is still there. And now is dominating this round as he did the last. Wild from Pascal and Crotch capitalising.
That's another good round by Crotch. Pascal looking more tired, more ragged in this round. Not being half as effective as he was previously.
He took a solid uppercut there under left hook to Pascal. And he looks tired, doesn't he? He's starting to look disorganised in there, and there's more of an air of desperation about his work. Crotch lands with terrific body shots and says, yeah, I'm the daddy. Well, has the fight now settled into a pattern? Has Carl Crotch assumed dominance? There's that uppercut, followed by a left hand, and Pascal took them both flush.
I've given the last two rounds to Carl Crotch. That could be the turn in this fight. That last round for me really was a real dominant round by Crotch.
Since those punches which Pascal threw after the bell, was it to end the fifth round? Since then, he hasn't quite looked the same man. But has he just taken a breather? Is he going to have his second wind? Pascal certainly looking as though he's bearing the marks of conflict more than Crotch, isn't he? Got swelling around those eyes. Crotch is so much happier if he can fight at this sort of pace. He's in his sort of comfort zone now. This is the pace at which Crotch likes to fight. And Pascal has got to raise it if he's going to win this title.
Absolutely. Crotch just walking around the ring now, getting his second wind. Just popping the jab. Pascal doing nothing more than just following him. Which I must say is very disappointing from my perspective. You know, Pascal is away from home.
Pascal takes another solid left hand. Tried to detonate the big right hand and another one, but Crotch sees it coming and just slips inside.
Has dropped very significantly in this round. Crotch just content just to win the round on the jab if he can, without exerting too much energy, trying to save it for the home stretch.
Pascal having another fairly quiet round here. He's looking a bit disorganised in there, for my way of looking at it.
at the end of the round. We're going to hear from former world featherweight champion Barry McGuigan and see what his reading of it is. We've got Froch now starting to establish a lead in this fight. Don't think that Pascal has clearly taken a round. I don't think he can argue a round for Pascal. Certainly since the fifth, but that's a good shot. And another. And another. Froch takes the ball. This is a good attack from Pascal. He needed this. And Froch is cut around the left eye. He's cut around the left eye. So it's going to be important for the corner. And Pascal has gained extra confidence from this. Almost down in the closing seconds. Now let's see what the damage is to that left eye of Karl Froch. They're going to have to work away to that. It's not on the eyebrow. Looks as though it might be the eyelid.
So I'm getting right in there. Carl, listen to me now. It's only a scratch, but you don't want to be getting it on that, all right, OK? You give him a bit of something to stay in there. You stand up tall swinging at him, he's going to hit your back, you know that. Just keep boxing.
This is how it happened.
Jab, all right? Shut your eye. Keep boxing his head off with a jab, do you understand?
We think.
Me? Keep boxing his head off with a jab.
It was he's blinking there. That was where the cut was. It may have been that slashing left hook that did it. Maybe the right.
How we doing?
But certainly at the end of that exchange, that was the damage.
Stand aside, that's not going in your eye. That's not going in your eye.
Corners, 10 seconds.
Do me a favour, mate, let's be on the ball here now. One, two. He's nearly ready to go, but don't load up your leg.
Hope springs anew for Jean Pascal.
Round 9.
Well, Pascal may have won that round, Duke.
I just gave it to Pascal. Froch just took his finger off the pulse and just let him creep back in towards the end of that round. But I've still got Froch winning. Froch has got to get busy again. Taking silly shots now. Got to keep his chin down and his hands up. The championship rounds, which we're entering into now, these are the ones that really count. This is where Froch really has to hold it together.
Looked as though he was slipping away from Jean Pascal. That suddenly the fight wide open again, and you can see that Pascal has really taken heart from the damage to Froch's eye, and he's blinking Froch. Good solid right hand from the British fighter.
Yeah, Froch has a lot of heart though. Cut or no cut, he'll fight till the end. He's winning this fight, I think. Just got to be careful of the overhand rights now from Pascal.
He was dabbing away to the grease above the left eye, was Froch. Maybe just affecting his vision a little. He's blinking a bit uncomfortably. Pascal only just off target with that massive left hook and another one. He's trying to knock Froch out with every punch he's throwing here now.
But he's got his second wind again, Pascal. This one's heating up again. Froch's chin's too high. Much too high.
Big body shot from Pascal gave that opening. Furious exchanges here again.
Where have they got the power from? Where have they got the energy from? I thought these two had punched themselves out and had resided themselves. They was going to have a boxing match. But now they're sucking it up again. Got their second win and they're trading the hard blows.
Pascal getting plenty of success in this round again.
One good shot either way and someone's going down.
They're getting more tired by the second. And as that happens, the punch resistance begins to erode. Good right hand from Froch. But Pascal, we talked a lot about Froch's chin, what about Pascal's?
Both boxers tired. Both boxers got wide open guards.
Who'd be a judge? Difficult one to score. So many power shots. Froch getting away with holding behind the head of Pascal.
Froch breathing really heavily in there. As is Pascal. Lovely shot by Froch. Stopped Pascal in his tracks. Needed it to win this round.
And he's hurting. He's hurting. And Pascal looking a little bit wild and a bit unsteady. Froch senses it. Big right hand from Pascal though.
Just for a minute, I thought Pascal's legs had gone. Froch landed a cracking right hand.
What a round that was. terrific shots. Work continuing on the left eye of Karl Froch. Well, you've heard how we sit. Let's hear how Barry McGuigan's got it. Barry.
What a fight. I'll tell you what, this has lived up to some of the best super middleweight fights I've ever seen. Absolutely breathtaking stuff the whole way through. Karl Froch is beginning to tire. Pascal, we thought, was tired two rounds back, but he showed he got something left, and yet he was badly hurt in that round. I still have Froch two rounds up, but this is going to be two of the hardest rounds of his life. What a fight.
Terrific fight. Duke's got it, Froch, by two rounds.
Two rounds for Froch. And two rounds to go, and there's nothing in it. I tell you, these two boys are exhausted, but I still fancy Froch.
Round 10.
And the excitement there, saying two rounds to go. In fact, we've got three rounds to go. But it could all still be at stake with these three rounds, and who would count out the possibility of a late stoppage one way or the other? Froch was the betting favourite for this fight at 72 on. Jean Pascal has made a nonsense of the bookies' prediction.
Absolutely, but these are the championship rounds where you really got to grit your teeth. If nobody's been cut, nobody's been knocked down, I should say. There is a cut in Froch's eye, but there hasn't been any knockdowns. A very cleanly fought contest, but this is what separates champion from challenger, and we're going to see who the champion is after this.
Pascal wanting to follow in the footsteps of men like Lalonde, like Hilton, like Luca. Froch trying to follow where Eubank, Ben, Collins, and of course Calzaghe went before. Who is to be the one who is to be dominant and maybe here prove that they are the best super middleweight in the world? And Froch lands two more terrific right hands as Pascal's right eye is getting worse and worse. It's looking a mess now there, and I just wonder whether his vision is starting to be affected. He's shipping a lot of punishment. Well, I think you can still see there, but there is swelling and he's blinking uncomfortably. Look,
Pascal really tired, as is Froch.
Froch trying to measure him now for the big right hand. The two of them look so tired. All those runs, all those hours in the gym, this is what it's all for.
Sure, the training camp gives you mental strength also. Both boxers are absolutely on their game. Froch, for me, though, just doing a slightly better work in this round.
Well, he's being told by the referee, pull his shorts up. The Froch fans don't like it. You saw one of Carl's brothers there getting very angry at ringside at that pause. The two of them are helping Froch do up his new house. I'm sure thoughts about that a long, long way away at this very moment. Pascal, and Froch just takes it once again. Right hand landed pretty flush. The chance of Nottingham got as the two men again land big shots. They're back on instinct once more.
Froch, for me, just pulling this round out.
Very, very important round, this one. Froch, through boxing ability and just working away behind that jab, has probably done enough. The two of them wander almost groggily back to their corners, and who can blame them?
Non, mais si on veut le fight, on va avoir une chance d'avoir le fight, ça me prend les deux derniers rounds en ligne.
He's been brave. He's fought his heart out. And again, phenomenal exchanges. There was that uppercut I was talking about, Duke. Landed flush.
It was a good shot by Pascal, but that was his only success for the round. After that was Froch with them little sneaky jabs that he likes to throw.
Keep a rhythm. Chin down. He's going to get desperate. He'll have a swing up, then he's going to tire, all right? Give me two rounds, real style. Yeah. Chin on your chest, let's switch, work your way now. In a rhythm, and long jabs and right hands. Yeah. Two rounds, come on.
This is the sort of fight where wise heads at ringside are all looking at each other and saying, how have you got it? Who's winning the fight? Most people are saying that Frotch has got it by maybe two or three. But that is just, in some cases, the view of people who are consumed by home bias and a wish to see Frotch win it. What matters is the judges. The men from Montenegro, from Mexico and the United States, if it goes the distance, how are they going to score it?
Well, Frotch doing the right thing in this one. Beautiful jab. Knocked Pascal's head right back with that jab. And that's what wins this fight for me over the down the stretch, is that jab from Frotch. If he can just keep popping the jab, not get too involved, don't go right hand happy.
Frotch has twice had to go the 12 round distance. Pascal's done it on three occasions. It's starting to look as though it could go right down to the wire, this one. Well, the left-hand, right-hand combination again makes Pascal look a little bit groggy. A little bit of a complaint to the Italian referee from Carl Frotch. I'm afraid in the cacophony here at ringside, not a prayer of telling you what it was. Oh, big right hand from Pascal! That was a really good shot from the Canadian. And it landed flush, and Frotch just took it.
I don't know where he summoned up a punch like that from this late in the fight.
That right eye is giving Pascal trouble.
He's wincing in there, John. He's wincing in there, closing the eye, squeezing it tightly shut.
He's up on his toes. Bit of kinology from Pascal. Oh, good shot from Frotch. And another one. And Pascal bravely comes back with hooks of his own. Frotch allowing himself to get dragged into that toe-to-toe exchange. This is a grueling, savage fight at times.
It's untidy, it's sloppy, but you know, we're so late into the fight, these guys want to win so bad.
It evokes memories of that first encounter all those years ago at the NEC in Birmingham between Chris Eubank and Nigel Benn. It's had that sort of ferocity, and that is some big thing to say, I tell you. Momentarily, Frotch choosing to go southpaw, and Pascal staggering forward drunkenly once more. Pascal had that good 15-second or 20-second flurry, and both of them are so tired. Last seconds of the 11th, and Frotch getting the better of that exchange again. The Nottingham crowd roar on the hero, and sense that that man might now just 3 minutes away from the title. Well, what a fight this has turned out to be. I think people who really knew their boxing knew this was going to be something very special, and it has turned out to fulfill every expectation.
It really hasn't disappointed. For me, this fight's had everything except a knockdown. It's ebbed and flowed every which way. But for me now, Frotch, I've got him a couple of rounds up. Just needs to stay calm, stay tight, box his way to a nice round, and he gets the championship.
There's Carl's mum leading the cheering and his girlfriend sitting there at ringside. And Carl Frotch may be 3 minutes away from the world title and a first step towards the superstardom he craves. Pascal will still believe he can turn around, but Frotch has bossed the second half of this fight by and large. What a fight. It's one of those where at times it's no exaggeration to say it has been a privilege to watch it. Displays of naked bravery from both men.
Well, this is where home advantage really pays dividends. You're in the final round, you're in front of your own people. You can smell, taste, feel victory, and these two are going at it again.
What a fight it is.
In the final round, John, they're still winging away. Somebody still wants to knock out.
They're shouting at Frotch in his corner to box, box. Just work on the jab and do that. Work behind your boxing skills. Don't get into that macho brawl. There's a little bit of a skirmish on the other side of the Atlantic later on tonight. It's going to have to go some to match this.
You know, you really couldn't blame Fuchs for getting on his bike and boxing his way in this last round. He must know he's a couple of rounds up. But still he goes for the knockout. Still he forces Pascal to fight, to stand and trade.
The chants and the songs begin. Is this to be the man who is to become the dominant figure in this division, just as Joe Calzaghe has been? Referee telling Froch off for pulling his man down. I'm not sure that's justified. I think there might have been as much tiredness from Pascal, who's really lurching forward and leaning into his shots now.
They're both boxers now, spaces. Show the scars of battle, but it's Froch who's putting in a grandstand finish.
Pascal has displayed tremendous bravery and great credit here, has fought superbly at times, and if he is to have lost, he's young enough to come again. But that's how we see it, remember. You'll have your own idea watching at home, and it all depends on the judges. 1 minute to go, less.
Pascal much more tired than Froch. They're both desperately tired, both sucking it up. But for me, Froch just winning this last round, just winning himself on.
7,000 people will rise in acclamation of this in the closing seconds as the two end the fight as they began, winging in colossal shots, somehow managing to force themselves forward and throw yet more. This has not been the prettiest fight, but it's in its way, this has been a classic. And what a fight! Punches after the bell, both men believe they could have won it. Team Pascal celebrates, the Froch team celebrates, and all around the Trent FM Arena, every single person is on their feet, applauding something which from the world of boxing was very, very special indeed. A superb fight. Breathtaking fight.
Well, the crowd are shouting easy, but it was anything but easy. Froch has had to work really extremely hard for victory.
We don't know yet, Duke.
I believe he's won. That's just my opinion. But I just think that, you know, he done so well from about round eight on. He pulled it out. He's shown a champion's heart.
He's being congratulated by his promoter, Mick Hennessy, as Carl Froch. And now being hugged by his brother and the other brother. Great family scene. They think they've done enough. And others making their way up. That's his mum who's got onto the ring apron now. There'll be a few celebrations, and that's the lady of Carl Froch's life. Pascal waving to the crowd, drawing the jeers. He thinks he's won it. He's certainly got no disgrace in defeat if he has been vanquished here. And Carl Froch, what a performance. He has proved emphatically for me that he is in every sense the genuine article. Barry McGuigan has it by four rounds for Carl Froch. There are a few rounds where I wouldn't like to separate them. There's so many people up there. That's Mum. She's happy. She thinks that her proud son is now world champion. Carl Froch must have won that last round. Final score from Duke McKenzie, we'll give you that in a moment. Barry's given it by four rounds to Carl Froch, and Duke has got it by five. Five rounds for Carl Froch, for Duke McKenzie. Are we to have a new British world champion? And in just a moment, I think the scorecards now have been collated. And I think we can go into the ring, and now we can find out who is the new WBC champion of the world. Froch thinks it's him.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards. Judge Tommy Kaczmarek scores it 118 to 110. Judge Arenio Cuevas scores it 117 to 111. And Judge Predrag Aleksic scores it 116 to 112. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. and the new WBC super middleweight champion of the world from Nottingham.
Got it. Karl Froch, the new WBC super middleweight champion of the world, and the judges gave it one by eight rounds, one by six, and one by four. And that fight is why we all love boxing. When you rejoin us here at the FM Arena, we will battle our way and try and get a world with the new champion of the world. We have a new world boxing champion. His name is Karl Froch. He's the new WBC super middleweight champion after an unbelievable fight against Jean Pascal. That belt round your waist, Karl. You've dreamed of that since you were 9 years of age.
This is unbelievable, the WBC champion. To be honest, when I turned professional, I never really had the WBC title in my sights. I wanted to take one goal at a time. First of all, the British, Commonwealth. I missed out on the European, the guy wouldn't fight me. And then, obviously, the WBC was my next goal. And to come here and win the WBC in front of me, his hometown fans in Nottingham, it's unbelievable, and I'm elated.
How tough was your opponent tonight, Jean Pascal, the Canadian?
You've got to give Jean Pascal every credit. He came here tonight undefeated, and he came and he had a go, and he was here to win. He wasn't here to lie down. I caught him with some really, really sweet, hard, accurate shots. I've hurt my hand on the top of his head. No problems. I know when it's broken, it's not broke. So there's no excuses for not finishing. This guy was world-class, top-quality opponent, and I did very well to outclass him, which I feel I did.
It was a spellbinding fight for everybody watching on ITV1. Those first three rounds, I mean, almost shades of Hagler Hearns there.
that's an honour for you to say that. But, yeah, I did feel like I caught him early cold in the first round. And like the warrior I am and the finisher I am, I went in there and I just thought, I better keep this cool because this kid's tough. I don't want to blow a gasket in round one. So I kept my composure, used my experience and just picked him off and won the first two or three rounds quite comfortably without going too mad.
Your man here in your corner, Robert McCracken, was going absolutely crackers at you because you weren't boxing, but you were giving us all a fight that very few people will forget in a hurry.
Rob wants me to box because he knows what boxing skills I've got. I can outbox anybody with my long jab. And Robert McCracken's come here tonight, and if I can just say something with the interview, I'd like to dedicate this fight to Christine McCracken. She passed away earlier this week. And it's very sad, and that's Robert's mother. So he's come here today, and I'd like to dedicate that fight to her.
You've done that, and obviously, Robert, our condolences on that, but give us your assessment of what your man did for you tonight.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's 7 months since Karl boxed. I think maybe a little bit too long, but Karl's a fantastic talent. We said it from day one. Everyone became believers after a couple of years, and that was the icing on the cake because that was a fantastic opponent in Jean Pascal. But Karl Froch is the best super middleweight in the world, and everybody knows it now, but we always knew it.
And just a final one for you. The trade paper Boxing News said superstardom beckons now for Karl Froch. You won't disagree with that, will you?
I won't disagree with that. I've got the best promoter in the world. I've got the best trainer in the world, Mick Hennessey, Robert McCracken. We've got a fantastic team, and we want to take over the world and bring unified belts back here to Nottingham in front of this fantastic crowd. Thanks very much to everyone for coming.
World champion Karl Froch, Robert McCracken, thank you very much indeed. Well done.
Thank you.